All right, so here's a map of water hardness across Canada. As you can see, different regions have harder water. As we see in different sites, the more north we go, the harder the water is, etc. Here's one of the US. So there is a company in the US that will test your water. We do have that option down here too, where you can test the hardness of the water. So for instance, if you put a filter system in and we're still getting scale buildup, it'd be a good time to test the water just to see if we can attack the scale more aggressively through the filters. All right, so mineral control through polyphosphates, mineral swap through softeners, and mineral removers through an RO system. So there are all different types of filters, as we know. Filtration does not remove hardness. And here's a basic setup. So we have our water coming in. Through the filter, we have a pre-filter, then it goes through the secondary filter, and then it goes into the unit. All right, here's just an example of scale buildup. And basically what happens, how we build scale is hydrogen carbonate transforms to carbonate and water CO2 while it's heating. Carbonate plus calcium forms calcium carbonate, which is scale. As we can see, this one's really bad. We can't even see through here, through this access port, check our water level probes. This is probably through the secondary low water cutoff. Okay, so here's just one thing that you can kind of explain to the customer why scale buildup's bad. Obviously, energy consumption. So scale acts like it's as an insulator, so it's around the element. It's around the tank. We can't really heat the water directly. So based on the thickness of the scale, so if you have 3/4 of an inch, it goes up to 90% loss of efficiency. So you'll find that that boiler will probably be running almost the entire day. And a good indicator of that is when you fire it up, it takes forever to get to temperature to your set PSI. Okay, so it reduces energy transfer. So rock, so that's like the harder types that we obviously see a lot of here. It acts as an insulator. So as we saw earlier, a 1/4 inch of scale equals 39% loss. It reduces the equipment life. Obviously the scale is eating away at all the components at the boiler walls. And then that leads to equipment downtime and warranty claims, which if it's scaled up and they haven't been descaling it, the warranty will be voided, and it leads to more service calls. So that's why it's important that the customer has a good filtration system and that the boiler's being cleaned out regularly. So in order to have warranty, you need proper maintenance, which includes descaling. Okay, a pressure boiler should be descaled every 120 days, okay? And that's if it meets the water quality. So that's when you do the test the water. And that's based on 10 hours a day, 7 days a week. And they want you to use their dissolved descaler. Can you descale too often? Yes, the acids will actually start to eat away at the boiler walls. Okay, so acid in a clean boiler attacks the boiler. What type of steam generators are there? There's two types, the pressure boiler and the atmospheric one. So water quality, So better water means you have to descale it less often. So that's your filtration system. And the harder the water is, the more often you're going to have to descale. Hours of use. So obviously somewhere like a school, it's not being used as often. It will not have to be descaled as often. Okay. And what type of descaling agent should you use? You should be using the dissolve. Some are more acidic, some less. And that's obviously important because we don't want the acid to attack the boiler walls. So we want to make sure we use the proper product. Okay, so on a boiler base, so this is where this is transferring steam to a kettle or a steam compartment that's through the steam hoses, okay? Okay, so do not descale a gas boiler with 4 to 6 inches of scale or more. The reason for that is it's actually insulating any cracks that might be in there. So if you try to go do that, and you're most likely going to get a leak. So unless the customer is basically telling you have to do this, it is not recommended with this type of scale on there. The boiler will most likely leak and that thing will be junk. Okay, whenever you descale, you should have a neutralizer or a box of baking soda just in case you spill the descaling agent. So for a boiler base, okay, for descaling, these are the steps. Okay, so first thing, turn off the steamer, verify it's empty. Okay, this sight glass here, it could be full because when we turn the switch off, we go down into our blowdown. Okay, usually it's up to 3 minutes, that blowdown. If it's slow to drain, this sight glass is actually going to fill up because when we go in our blowdown, we're introducing water in there. So we can move any scale, push any scale off every time we turn the unit off. Okay, so you want to do your blowdown. And then at that point, you would come and remove this handhold plate. At that point, you remove as much scale as possible by hand. So you just put your hand and arm in there. Take as much as you can. You want to remove the anodes. Okay, you want to put back the handhold and change the gasket if needed. At that point, we're going to turn on the steamer. Okay, so you're going to let the steamer fill. Okay, once it's full, you're going to remove this plug here at the pressure relief valve. Okay, and you're going to add 2 gallons of the descaling agent. It's recommended, obviously, to use a funnel here. Okay, at this point, if you have a cooking cabinet above it, you want to turn it on and open the door. And at this point, we're going to remove the high probe, the high water probe from the unit. It should be the black one. At this point, now you're going to let the unit fill until it enters the top cabinet. Okay, as soon as it enters the top cabinet, you want to turn off the water to the unit. Okay, so once it gets in that top cabinet, you want to clean clean that top cabinet, use a neutralizer, clean it out. That stuff is pretty corrosive. Now it's not really food safe either. Okay, at that point, you want to let the descaler sit for about 2 hours. Okay, once that's done, you're going to turn off the steamer. Okay, and you're going to turn on the water. This is going to put us into another blowdown. It's going to go for about 3 to 5 minutes. Then you're going to turn on the steamer. Okay, let it fill again until the water goes into the top cabinet. And then you're going to turn it off and let it drain. You're going to do this 2 more times. Okay. Okay, now with the steamer off, remove the handhold plate. You're going to clean the water level probes. You're going to hang the anode and clean stay rod. You're going to reinstall the handhold plate. You're going to remove and clean the secondary low water cutoff, which is located right here. And then replace the gasket. Okay, at this point, you're going to reattach the high water probe. Okay, because we don't want it to overfill, obviously. Okay, you're going to turn on the steamer, close the cabinet door. You're going to start the boiler. So once the boiler fills, The reset light's going to come on. You're going to click the reset switch. Now we're going to steam it for 20 minutes. We're going to check for any leaks. Okay. We're going to test the pressure relief valve right here. Okay. That needs to be tested every time we descale the boiler. Okay. At that point, once the 20 minute steam's done, turn off the steamer and that's the end of the process. Okay. Here they discuss a deliming pump kit. Just to make things a little bit faster. It's not something that we utilize. Okay, so just quickly, can you descale too often? Yes, the acids will attack the boiler walls. Any scale on a gas boiler, 4 to 6 inches thick, do not remove the scale. It'll most likely start leaking because it's probably acting as an insulator in whatever cracks might be in there. Okay, pressure relief valve must be tested after every descale. And if they haven't been doing any PMs or descaling, the warranty would be voided at that point. Okay, now we're gonna go over to the atmospheric steam generators. So this is a self-contained unit. Okay, atmospheric generators need to be descaled more often. They can be descaled every 4 to 6 weeks by the customer. So the customer will come up here, take this cap off, pour it in. Your customer can do that every 4 to 6 weeks. Half a gallon of dissolve for tabletops and 1 to 2 gallons for the floor model. So this would be the tabletop. This would be the floor model. As you can see, one's bigger than the other. That's why we need more dissolve in there. And then beware of foam. So what that means is when we pour it through, it's coming through this tube right here. Okay. It's going to come through here and then it has to go through a 90 right here. If there's any scale in this 90, okay, which there usually is because now water's been sitting there. It's hard to drain it in that section. When the customer goes to pour this in, as soon as we hit scale, it's going to start foaming up. So it's going to start foaming. It'll foam back and the customer will think, oh, okay, I've put enough in. I'm good. Okay. But as we saw up here, we need to put half a gallon. So you need that foam to go back down and you would put it back. And then if you notice when you're doing it, that's happening, this hose would have to come off and you'd have to chisel out or break out any scale that's inside this 90 and then repeat the process. And here we're just showing the view of the boiler from the side. Okay, so the boiler can be removed easily. It's actually pretty intense removing this boiler. But it can be removed for intense descaling for, because you got to remember if you're trying to go through this element hole here and there's scale all the way back here, you're not going to be able to get it. Okay. And it doesn't matter how much descaler you're in there. If that thing's, you know, 1 inch thick, like it's something you have to take apart. Okay. So scale doesn't like to stick to stainless. So what you can do is flex the, you can flex the boiler, meaning you can lightly tap the walls, okay, with a rubber mallet, and it should flake right off that wall, okay, because it doesn't like to stick to stainless. Okay, that's when you have it removed from the unit so that you can watch, okay, where's there a lot of scale build off? Okay, let me go lightly hammer in that area with a mallet. All right, so this is the procedure for doing, for descaling. So turn the steamer off, let it drain. Turn on the steam in time mode and put no time on the timer, okay? So why we do that? We don't want the unit to heat. So there will still be some heat. If we look here, there's a preheat element. We're gonna have minimal heat from that, okay? So it's important that we do this when we're not heating, okay? Remove the descale cap, add the proper amount of dissolve. Okay, add more water to the descale port until water enters the cabinet. So you'll open the door, you'll see it overflowing from the boiler into the cabinet. Okay, now we know we're full, okay? You want to clean that water mix that's spilled into the cabinet with a neutralizer. Now you want to let it dissolve. So this one, we only need 1 to 2 hours, depending on how badly it's scaled. So some of our customers are every 6 months, so you could probably get away with the 1 hour descale if it's being done every 6 months, but also depending on water hardness and filters and all that good stuff. Okay, so now you're gonna turn the steamer off, it's going to drain, so it's going to go into a blowdown. So you're going to turn it back on, okay? And then it's going to fill, and you're going to add water one more time through here so that water comes into the cabinet, okay? So we're going to overfill the boiler, okay? We're going to do that two more times, okay? So we're going to drain it, we're going to refill it, we're going to overfill it. And then we're going to steam the unit for 20 minutes, okay? After 20 minutes, the customer can get the steamer back. Okay, so this is the Steamcraft unit. Okay, so just quickly, these are the steam solenoids. Okay, that's allowing steam into there. And then these are the relief valves. Okay, this is going down into the drain. So that's how we're controlling how much steam can go into the cabinet. Okay, we have the mechanical timer at the top, the buzzer, our 3-second timer. The drain handles, your drain valves in the back here, your high limit in the back as well. We have our steam traps. Here's the steam generator or the boiler. Probe housings, the check valves, and then our pressure relief here, which we, as we know, we always need those on a boiler. Because if we always overpressurize, that thing basically becomes like a bomb. So we want to be able to release the pressure at a certain pressure so we don't build up too high. And here's just an example of a unit that's been way overscaled. As you can see, you can't even get in here. This would probably be one that you'd have to probably remove it from the unit and flex it and just put descaler in it. And you can see here, this is more or less what it should look like. We have some light scaling in here, but there's not a huge block. So this is how we would descale the atmospheric steam generator. All right, so they're using the pump here, but we could easily just go through this descaling port at the top. Okay. And pour in our solution from there. So with the atmospheric, same as the pressure boilers, you can descale them too often. Any gas drainer that has 4 to 6 inches of scale, do not descale them. They are most likely going to leak if you remove that. Be aware of foam, meaning if it foams up. So we get foam when foam hits scale and there's no water there. It doesn't mean it's full. It means that it's hit scale. Okay, you need to add the total recommended amount. And same thing, if they're not doing PMs or descaling, the warranty will be voided. Okay. So now let's go into some bad installations. So this one is right next to a fryer and a salamander. Okay. And then also the grill on the bottom. So what happens is grease can fill the louvers, blocking airflow. As we know, airflow is very important for electrical components. In this case, the steam solenoid failed because of too much heat in here. So this would be an incorrect installation. There are clearances that we need to follow.